Jai Hind, everyone. So we are here to study English of class 9th. I hope you might have watched the last video. We have seen the introduction of the syllabus. Since you were from class 8th and you were going to class 9th, you might be feeling a bit difficulty, but I'm telling you, it's very easy. For that only I introduced the syllabus and paper pattern in the last class. Now we'll start with the first book, Beehive, which I have mentioned in the last video. And chapter 1 is The Fun They Had. The Fun They Had is the name of the chapter, and it's written by Isaac Asimov. Now let's see something about the author. So introduction of the author. It won't be there in your exam, don't panic. It's just for your benefit. You must be good enough to know something about the order. You must be knowing something. For that knowledge's sake, we are just introducing the order. Don't you worry. So scholar Isaac Asimov was one of the 20th century's most prolific writers, writing in many genres. The name of the order is Isaac Asimov. Ye 20th century ke sabse zyada fruitful, सक्सेसफुल राइटर थे और ये बहुत सारे जेनर्स में लिखते थे. ही वॉज नोन फॉर साइंस फिक्शन वर्क्स लाइक फाउंडेशन एंड मी एंड रोबोट. ये इनके कुछ वर्क्स हैं, फेमस वर्क्स, फाउंडेशन एंड मी, रोबोट, और ये साइंस फिक्शन लिखते थे. जो स्टोरीज हम लोग पढ़ते हैं वो अलग अलग टाइप के होते हैं, जैसे फिक्शनल स्टोरीज. फिक्शनल स्टोरीज वो होते हैं जो इमेजिनरी होती है, फिक्शन मीन्स इमेजिनरी, और ये साइंस फिक्शन लिखते थे. साइंस फिक्शन मीन्स इमेजिनेशन इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ साइंस. नाउ लेट्स हैव समथिंग अबाउट हिज पर्सनल लाइफ. ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 2nd January इन 1920 इन पेट्रोविकी, रशिया. आइसक एसिमोव इमिग्रेटेड विद हिज फैमिली, मीन्स ही वेंट टू यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स एंड बिकम अ बायोकेमिस्ट्री प्रोफेसर. सो ही वॉज साइंस स्टूडेंट ऑल्सो while pursuing writing, and meanwhile he used to write these things. And his first novel was published in 1950, and the name of the novel was Pebble in the Sky. Now here's one of the works you are going to study, and the name of the chapter is The Fun They Had. Let's have an introduction of the chapter. This story is set in future, when books and schools as we have now perhaps will not exist. So ये माना जा रहा है according to Isaac Asimov कि जैसे स्कूल और बुक्स अभी के ज़माने में हैं, वो फ्यूचर में नहीं रह जाएंगे. टू स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ दैट पीरियड अबाउट 150 years एडवांस फ्रॉम टुडे फाइंड अ प्रिंटेड बुक. और उस ज़माने में, आज से 150 साल बाद के ज़माने में, जब आज की तरह स्कूल और आज की तरह बुक्स नहीं रह जाएंगे, तब के ज़माने में दो स्टूडेंट्स को क्या मिलता है, एक प्रिंटेड बुक, मतलब इस समय के ज़माने की बुक मिल जाती है. दे आर सरप्राइज्ड वेरी मच. और अगर आपको इस टाइम में लीव्स पे लिखी हुई एक बुक मिल जाए तो थोड़ा सा सरप्राइज होगा, सिंस यू आर स्टडिंग ऑन बुक्स विच आर प्रिंटेड ऑन पेपर. सो दे आर इन फ्यूचर they'll be more advanced, they'll be studying on computers, and when they find a book, printed book, which is printed on paper, they were surprised to get it. They talk about the school and books of the old period. और उस book को मिलने के बाद वो पुराने ज़माने के school और books के बारे में बात करते हैं. They talk about the schools and books of the old period. They compare those schools with those of their own which are situated in their home and have mechanical teacher to teach them. तो इनके स्कूल कैसे होंगे, इनके घर में ही रहेंगे इनके स्कूल, और कोई तो कंप्यूटर सा सिस्टम रहेगा, एक मैकेनिकल टीचर रहेगा, मैकेनिक्स वाला रोबोट, और वो पढ़ाएगा. एंड दे वर कंपेयरिंग दैट स्कूल जो उनके घर में है कंप्यूटर वाला, एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ स्कूल. They find their own school dull and boring. As you people don't like your schools. Or do you? You must be liking your schools. They also liked your school. उनको भी आज के ज़माने का स्कूल ही पसंद था जो इस समय है, और उनको अपना खुद का स्कूल डल और बोरिंग लगता था. दे थिंक दैट इट वॉज ग्रेट फन टू स्टडी इन द स्कूल ऑफ ओल्ड टाइम्स, और उनको लगता था कि बहुत मज़ेदार था कैसे स्कूल में पढ़ना, उन स्कूलों में पढ़ना जो पुराने ज़माने के स्कूल थे. और कैसे स्कूल्स थे पुराने ज़माने के उनके अकॉर्डिंग, when all the kids in the area went there where to the schools to learn the same thing by a man teacher. और सारे बच्चे एक एरिया के कहाँ जाते थे, एक बिल्डिंग में जाते थे, और उनका टीचर कैसा होता था, एक मैन टीचर होता था, एक ह्यूमन बीइंग होता था. सो दिस इज़ द होल स्टोरी. स्टोरी सेट कहाँ है, फ्यूचर में है, 2157 में, सात से करीब 150 साल बाद की स्टोरी है. और दे आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट, दे आर एक्चुअली कंपेयरिंग दीज स्कूल्स विच यू हैव टुडे एंड दो स्कूल्स विच दे यू विल हैव इन फ्यूचर विच दे हैड इन देयर प्रेजेंट, जो उनके प्रेजेंट में थे और जो आपके प्रेजेंट में हैं, उन दोनों स्कूल्स का कंपैरिजन है. और जैसा कि चैप्टर का नेम है द फन दे हैड, जो दोनों बच्चे हैं उनको क्या लगता था कि जो पुराने ज़माने के स्कूल्स हैं, मतलब जो आपके ज़माने के स्कूल्स हैं, वो काफ़ी बेटर थे एंड दे यूज़ टू हैव फन. नाउ थीम ऑफ द चैप्टर, ये चैप्टर क्यों पढ़ाया गया है, कुछ तो रीज़न होगा इस चैप्टर को पढ़ाने के पीछे. सो द मेन थीम इज़ दैट एजुकेशन, एजुकेशन हैज़ डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स. टुडे यू आर स्टडिंग ऑन योर मोबाइल फ़ोन और ऑन योर कंप्यूटर्स. जब आप स्कूल आते हैं यू स्टडी ऑन द बोर्ड, वाइट बोर्ड और ब्लैक बोर्ड और ग्रीन बोर्ड. So that is what is being shown here by the short stories, that education have different dimensions, and whatever you have, people don't like that. Us zamane ke bacche wo nahi pasand kar rahe hain aaj ke zamane ke bacche aaj. So this education is basically highlighted here, and also it's a imaginary story, science fiction hai, kyunki aaj se 150 saal baad ka scenario hame nahi pata hoga. So the writer has just imagined it, it's his imagination kaisa hoga. More specifically, the narrative deals with the future of education, ki aaj se future mein education kaise change hoga, which will become increasingly computerized and estranged from social interaction. तो future generation के school कैसे हो जाएंगे, ज़्यादातर computerized हो जाएंगे और estranged हो जाएंगे, अलग हो जाएंगे social interaction से. social gathering नहीं होगी जैसे आप लोग अभी करते हैं school में, वैसा नहीं होगा, अकेले एक room में बैठ कर एक बच्चा अपने घर पढ़ेगा. so this theme has been highlighted. see this is a picture, ये आपके NCERT book के पहले पेज की picture है. This is what is shown, schools of future, how it will look like. There will be a virtual classroom, aise classroom will be there. Or there will be a system. The student has to go and sit on the seat and you have to learn through this computer, see. There will be a mechanical teacher, robotic, and there will be moving e-text. You don't have to do anything. The text will be moving on your screen as you keep on reading, see. The time will be digitalized. ओके, नाउ द टाइटल जस्टिफिकेशन, ये टाइटल क्यों रखा गया है, क्या आप इसको जस्टिफाई कर सकते हैं, क्या आप कह सकते हैं टाइटल सही है? हाँ, आप कह सकते हैं. इन दिस स्टोरी, सी इन दिस पिक्चर देयर आर टू, अ गर्ल एंड अ बॉय, एंड एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड इन इंट्रोडक्शन देयर आर टू स्टूडेंट्स. तो ये जो बॉय स्टूडेंट है, द नेम ऑफ द बॉय स्टूडेंट इज टॉमी, नेम ऑफ द गर्ल स्टूडेंट इज मार्गी. So Margie and Tommy are there in this story. Title justification, let's just go through. The title is written here, the title quite suits the story. The title is suitable for the story, and as I also feel it is suitable, because these two students, Margie and Tommy, they find an old book and learn how were the schools different in past from their time. They get a printed book, they read that book, and they discuss that what's the difference between their school and these kind of schools. And they also think how much fun the children would have had बच्चों को कितना अच्छा लगता रहा होगा व्हेन द स्टूडेंट्स यूज टू गो इन स्कूल्स एंड ऑल टुगेदर दे यूज टू सिट एंड मैन टीचर ह्यूमन बीइंग यूज टू कम एंड टीच देम एंड ऑल्सो इट दिस चैप्टर गिव्स सम ग्लिम्सेस ऑफ फ्यूचर एजुकेशन फ्यूचर में एजुकेशन का क्या लेवल होगा दैट इट शोज नाउ दिस इज अ चैप्टर लेट्स जस्ट सी वंस व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड We have seen the chapter, this book is English Beehive book. The chapter name is The Fun They Had and it's written by Isaac Asimov. We have seen the introduction of the author. He was a very prolific writer of 20th century. He was born on 2nd January 1920 in Petroviki, Russia. And then he immigrated. He went to United States and there he became a biochemistry professor. Meanwhile, he continued his writing and he was born, in 1920 and he's published his first novel, Pebble in the Sky. The name of the novel is Pebble in the Sky. He published this novel in 1950. Introduction of the chapter. We have seen the story is set in future, about 150 years advanced from today. And in that advanced time when there was no printed books and all the schools were highly computerized and there were robotic teachers, in that era there were two students, Margie and Tommy, they found a printed book. And when they read the book, they found out that schools of that time were what? A building where all the students of our area went and studied all together. They found it very interesting. Unko bahut acha laga. And they found their school very dull and boring. Very dull and boring. They thought they have to go and sit in front of computer and they have to do the work all alone. So they found it boring and they just imagined the fun they had. The fun which you people are having these days. So what the theme is, why is this story taught to you? It just want to tell you about the education system. Which you are in and which future students will be in. And it also throws some light on how there's advancement in education system and how in future the schools will be computerized and students will be kept away from social interactions. Justification of the title we have seen because this Margie and Tommy, they appreciate the schools of olden times and they feel the fun they had. They were thinking, imagining about the fun which you people are having in these days. So the title is quite suitable. It is justifiable. We have seen this picture. How do they learn? They learn through computer. They have virtual. Virtual means that is not real. What are real classrooms? Which you people have. People sit in a room. All the students gather there. A teacher comes and teaches. That is real classroom for you people. So they had virtual classroom. They had robotic teacher. Who had no feelings, who just wanted the homework to be done, the test to be done. So this Margie was very much irritated by all these things. Tommy also was okay, but Tommy found the book. So Tommy was a bit superior because he was having the printed book. We'll see that in the story. Don't worry about it. Their textbooks were moving e-text. The text used to move on screen and they used to study. And the teacher was robotic and they used to learn through computer. So here one boy is highlighted and here one girl. This girl, there are two characters in the story. One boy, Tommy, and one girl, Margie. So this is a chapter. We'll see this chapter. We'll start one by one line explanation in the next class. Till then, you have to complete all these things in your copy. Take the copy, put the heading, write something, two lines, three lines about the author you can write, which you feel quite suitable. It will be 2-3 lines, won't be hectic, and just write the introduction of the chapter. It will help you a lot. Theme of the chapter, this introduction will help you to study, means to go through the chapter very easily. Theme also you can go through. Justification of the title, see, title justification is asked in the exams these days. Theme and title justification, so I just mentioned it. Write it down. Please complete all the notes so that we'll we may start this chapter from the next class. Let's see what is this. I'll just show you the book, as you might not be having. Before you read, it's given the story we shall read is set in the future. As I already told, the school, the story is set in future. When the books and schools as we now know them will perhaps not exist. Jo school aaj kal hum log jante hain, will perhaps not exist. How will children study then? Aise schools nahi rahenge to bacche kaise padhenge? The diagram below may give you some ideas. So this diagram we have seen. Now it is asked to discuss in pairs, and don't discuss anything in pair because social gathering is not allowed. Okay, now we'll see this chapter. It starts with Margi. Okay, it's a diary entry of Margi as written here. And on the diary entry, the date is 7th May 2157. And on that page, it was written, "Today, Tommy found a real book." So in the first paragraph, both the characters are introduced. This chapter is diary entry of Margi. Margi has written in her diary. And the date was 17 May 2157. And what she wrote in her diary, "Today, Tommy found a real book." So I hope you'll be excited for the chapter. You must be and you should be. We'll go through the chapter from the next class because it will take time. Do all this as your homework. Don't forget to please write it down in your copies. It will be easier for you to revise and to study and even to understand the chapter if you go through all these slides. That's all for today. Thank you very much. Have a good day.